Listen, I've been doing a lot of thinking about what you said. Never mind all the reasons not to date somebody. What does your heart say? Because mine says to give this a chance.
Oh.
Can I take you to dinner?
Well, actually, I'm getting on a plane tonight.
Where are you going?
Hawaii.
I see. With somebody?
Actually. Yes.
Is it my mother?
Technically. Yes.
I see. Have a lovely time. Sorry to bother you.
I felt like a deer in the headlights. I hope I didn't hurt her.
At least my mother taught me how to tackle. Goodbye, Denny Crane. Oh, and tell Bella, she better watch her back. My client's wife needed heart surgery. And so our HMO stuck her on a plane and sent her to India to have it, where she died on the table. The reason she was sent to India is because it's cheaper. It's called medical outsourcing. It goes on all the time, and I'm sure you know this. And you know what? If I needed surgery, I might consider making the schlep. Why should I pay $90,000 for heart surgery when I can get the same thing over there for 10? The problem is that Cindy Potter didn't get to make that choice. Because when she signed on with Wellness Healthcare, all the surgeries were done here. When that policy was modified, she couldn't switch HMOs. Because by then, she had a pre-existing heart condition and nobody else would take her. At least not at a price that she could afford. So she had to get on that plane. My client here, he had to work. He couldn't go with her, and his wife died on the other side of the world. Now, I can't really put a price tag on that. Can you? Now, I know it's not the defendant's fault that medical expenses are out of control here. I don't blame the defendant that half of Americans are uninsured. In fact, I give them credit for searching for a solution. But come on, shipping a patient with a heart condition to India is not a solution. It can't be. We have to be better than that. This is America. They should be banging down Congress's doors. They find it cheaper to go to India. And 4-1, that's 1.5 canes in metric.
You don't look a day over 4 feet. I saw in the file that her dad was normal sized.
It's average sized.
Compared to you, I'm sure it was huge. So did he have a fetish, or did he just fall in love with your long-legged soul?
He grew up in the circus. Said I reminded him of home. Seems like you're the one with the fetish.
I'm certainly curious about the logistics. Did you stand on a table?
House. Pretty much he'd lay flat and spin me.
Mom.
So, Abigail, you want to hop up on the table for me?
That's gonna be tough.
Stop treating her like she's five. Just bring over a stool and let her climb up herself.
I'm just trying to be helpful.
She also hates Jews.
I've dealt with worse. Being different, you get used to people's idiocy. Still beats the hell out of actually being an idiot. What?
Care to go for a spin?
Am I late? Sorry if I am. I had to drop Pokey off at daycare. Yes, daycare. I needed the rest. He cries all night. I am sleep deprived, and it's your fault.
My fault.
You rocked Andrew to sleep every night when he was a baby. He rocked Pokey to sleep every night. He left us, and I can't rock Pokey the same way he did. Bastard. He was making Pokey rely on him. Why did you let us get married? We weren't compatible.
Andrew always told me you were very compatible.
Sexually, that's it. As soon as the baby came into it, we were finished. It's this generation of men, they think they never have to grow up.
Excuse me. They never see me.
They never stop seeing me. Over here! Hey! Now, Max, his generation accepted what it meant to be grown up. How long have you two been married?
25 years.
And you still love each other. Whatever, passion isn't everything. I proved that. The chicken salad, dressing on the side, and a latte.
Me too.
Me too what? What does that mean? The latte, the salad?
Excuse me. Hey, look at me! Is this rudeness deliberate, or are you just lacking social skills?
I beg your pardon?
I beg your pardon? Now she's Miss Manners. Are you picking on my mother-in-law because she's a housewife who reminds you of your own mother who you probably despise? Or is it that my being a dwarf makes you so uncomfortable, but you know you'll be fired if you aren't polite to a dwarf?
I'll be right back with your order.
Why don't you take a picture? It lasts longer.
I'm sorry, I don't recognize her. And a girl this pretty, I would remember. The guys would still be drooling.
Well, according to the police, there's no one named Danielle registered at the hotel or at the convention.
You expected an internet handle to be a real name? Maybe the girl got cold feet. My first IOLP convention, I walk in, see 200 dwarfs staring back at me. And what goes through my head? There's no way I look like these people. I ran.
But you went back.
Eventually. I guess I realized it's nice to see eye to eye with someone. I get the impression that's a little tough for you. The freaks had looked at her in a secret way and tried to connect their eyes with hers, as though to say, we know who you are. We are you.
Faulkner.
Close. Another Southern writer. Carson McCullers.
I think we look for the differences in each other to prove that we're not alone.
What's yours? Your difference. Mine's the worst. Random gene. Anyone can have a dwarf. Sometimes I've even seen Tara in average-sized people's eyes. I remind them that they're little carbon copies. Might not be such a copy after all. You are a sicko, disgusting sleaze.
It's sexual, this ear pinch.
Yes. When's the last time you got that without taking a pill?
Why don't you come downstairs and check out what's cooking on the ground floor?
I will mop up the courtroom floor with you, you fat old man.
You need a telephone book or something?
Kiss my ass.
The dwarf fainted.
It's little person, asshole.
But I'm supposed to know that.
You know, you're not so tall yourself.